Yo, what up guys, I'm Sammy, welcome back to the Soul Brothers channel, and today I'm gonna be doing a versus video between the Nike Zoom Freak 1 and the Nike Zoom Freak 2. So both of these shoes retail for $120. The Zoom Freak 1, of course, is on sale. I've seen some of the colorways go for like 80, 90 bucks if you guys do wanna cop. And if you guys wanna cop the Zoom Freak 2 as well, I will leave links to both of the shoes down in the comment section below. This colorway is going for 130 bucks, but the general release colorway is going for 120 bucks, the black one with the translucent outsole. So they're basically the same price, and today we're gonna see which one performs better. So let's get it started off with the traction. So for the traction, I was playing outdoors with the Zoom Freak 1, and the Zoom Freak 1 had pretty good traction. It would slide out a little bit though. If I was doing a really hard lateral movement, or basically like any type of hard movement, it would slide out a little bit. You know, the Zoom Freak 2, I had no issues with. And of course, I did play with the Zoom Freak 1s on an indoor court, and it had a really good bite on an indoor court. Obviously, I don't really know on the Zoom Freak 2. Sorry about that, guys. But on my wood floors, it feels really, really nice. As far as durability goes though, I don't know, guys. I thought the Zoom Freak 2 would be an improvement, but it kind of isn't. The Zoom Freak 1 had parts of the outsole where it was super durable. Like this rose petal pattern is very, very hard rubber, and that's very durable. But this herringbone pattern is very, very soft rubber, and it kind of rips off. Like on my orange pair, I have a good amount of it ripping off. So there are parts of the outsole where the Zoom Freak 1 is not durable, and same thing with the Zoom Freak 2. Like if they just kept it this thick line rippling out throughout this 4 foot, it would have been fine. But then they separated it and made it into nubs for some reason. And where the nubs are, especially where the ball of your foot is, like here on the medial side, it's not that durable. You know, there are nubs ripping off for me and fraying off. I have no issues where the thicker lines are though. So I don't know why they did that at all, but it is what it is. And as far as durability, I would pretty much tie it up. Another difference is that the Zoom Freak 2 has a decoupled outsole. The Zoom Freak 1 is a fully one-piece outsole. All right, as far as the heel to toe transition goes, they're both super smooth. You know, you have a nice curved shape here in the heel, as well as in the forefoot. You have that nice rocking motion. Both of them have a good amount of flex in the forefoot as well, the Zoom Freak 1, right? It's more in the midfoot kind of, but it still flexes, so they're both very fluid, very, very smooth. All right, moving on to the cushioning setup. They're both ass, you know, impact protection is not good. They both pretty much feel the same. The only thing that's different is the Zoom unit. So in the Zoom Freak 1, you have a double stack Zoom unit here in the heel. And then in the Zoom Freak 2, you have a single Zoom unit in the forefoot. And just from preference and just what I like, I like the 4 foot Zoom unit a little bit better. I don't like Zoom units in the heel all too much. It's like this really skinny rectangle, you know? I can't really feel it all too much, especially when you're playing. Like when you're playing, you're more like on your toes, you know? So I just prefer the Zoom Freak 2. They're both low to the ground. Heel compression, there's really none. I guess besides your heel kind of digging into the Zoom unit, but as far as the midsole goes, there's really none in the Zoom Freak 1. So they're both ass, but the Zoom Freak 2 is a little bit less ass, so I guess the Zoom Freak 2, just in my preference, is a little bit better. Obviously, if you want a Zoom unit in the heel, go with the Zoom Freak 1. All right, moving on to the materials, that is a big win for the Zoom Freak 2. So the Zoom Freak 1, it's like this really flimsy, crappy feeling material. It looks cheap, it feels cheap in the hand, you know? And it's just, it wasn't nice. And a lot of people had that complaint on this shoe. Like on foot though, it's not that bad. You know, it breaks in pretty nicely. It gets pretty soft. It's very, very thin, very minimal. So I didn't really mind it as much. But the Zoom Freak 2 is a very big improvement. It's like a textile material and it's a lot softer. Feels great on foot and even feels a lot better in hand as well. So a Zoom Freak 2 has better materials, but then the tongue is basically the same. As you guys can see, it's an oversized tongue. They both have a lot of padding, which I love. And then they both have a lot of padding in the ankle area as well, which feels great. So the Zoom Freak 2 basically just improved upon the Zoom Freak 1 as far as the materials go. You know, they kept what I loved on the Zoom Freak 1 and just made it better quality, which I really like. Moving on to the fit, they both fit basically the exact same and I love it. I went true to size and they both fit me like a glove. So my toes go pretty much right to the edge of both of the shoes. Width-wise, pretty much the same, slightly narrow, and as far as the toe space goes, they're both pretty damn snug, which I really like. And then both of them are also pretty damn narrow here into the midfoot as well. So I really like the fit. If you have a wide foot or a thick foot, a big thick foot, or you want a roomier fit in your shoes, then I would suggest going up half a size or maybe even a full size, because this shoe fits very, very snug. And obviously, if you've tried the Zoom Freak 1 out and you know what size you are, that's probably what size you are here in the Zoom Freak 2. Moving on to the support in lockdown, also no issues at all. The Zoom Freak 1, as you guys can see, here in the heel, you got the swoosh coming up and also this rubber here, I guess more in the forefoot area. So lateral containment was good. Here in the Zoom Freak 2, you got this rubberized plastic and also the foam coming up here in the heel. So lateral containment was good as well in the Zoom Freak 2. And as for lateral stability, I was good in both. You know, the Zoom Freak 2 actually has an outrigger. The Zoom Freak 1 kind of doesn't, but then you guys can see that the rubber does protrude out a little bit here. I wonder which one is overall wider. Let's see. They're around the same, actually. They're on the same width. Actually, the Zoom Freak 1 might be a tad bit wider. But anyways, yeah, I had no issues with lateral instability or anything. I didn't feel like I was going to roll my ankle, so that's good. And they're basically both lows. But then the Zoom Freak 1 kind of covers your ankle bone right here. You see how this part kind of like comes up? The Zoom Freak 2, it's more of a low. So your ankle bone is basically exposed right here. And I like the feeling of that a little bit better in the Zoom Freak 2. Yeah, I just can have a little bit more freedom. I don't really like to have anything on my ankle bone. So that's just a personal preference, but I'm sure most people don't really mind it. All right, as for the weight, if I remember correctly, the Zoom Freak 1 was a little bit lighter. Yeah, so it's 10.86 ounces. And then the Zoom Freak 2 was like 11. Yeah, so 11.6. So like around 0.8 ounces lighter for the Zoom Freak 1. Not a huge difference, but it is a little bit lighter. And that's probably because these overlay materials, you know, like this plastic piece. On the medial side, you had this like synthetic material. The Zoom Freak 1 really had nothing. It was just this mesh material throughout the entire upper. So that's probably why it's a little bit lighter. What feels lighter? Both feel very, very light on foot. And you definitely feel like the padding, which feels very comfortable. And also, they're both very, very minimal feeling shoes as well. Even though they have like a lot of padding, I don't know what it is. Like, they feel very minimal to me. Probably because of the forefoot material being so thin. So if you want a light and minimal shoe, they're both really, really good. If you want the slightly more minimal and slightly lighter shoe, then go with the Zoom Freak 1. But it's really not that big of a difference. All right, moving on to the ventilation. They're both pretty damn warm. If you blow through basically these materials, like, there's no airflow, there's no ventilation or anything, so it kind of traps that moisture, and it gets pretty hot in the shoe. Or maybe it's because I was playing in like 95 degree weather outside. It's been super hot here in California with all the fires and this heat wave and stuff, so maybe that's the problem. But you know, when I was playing, my feet were kind of hot. As far as the aesthetics go, I don't know. I feel like I like the Zoom Freak 2 a little bit better. The Zoom Freak 1 was also a pretty good looking shoe to me, in my opinion. I just don't really like the big reversed swoosh as much. So for me, I prefer the Zoom Freak 2. Tell us what you guys think looks better down in the comment section below. So wrapping things up, Nike did a very, very good job of improving the Zoom Freak 1. And I would say it plays exactly like the Zoom Freak 1, but then just plays a little bit better. You know, better materials, the cushioning I like better as well with the 4-foot Zoom unit. Traction is a little bit better, and I guess a little bit more durable. But you know, basically the overall feeling of the shoe is still the same, right? You got the very, very well padded tongue and ankle area. It's super minimal here in the 4-foot. Very, very low to the ground cushioning setups, and a very responsive feeling shoes as well. So if you like the Zoom Freak 1 and you want a little bit more of an improvement, then go with the Zoom Freak 2. And I would say the Zoom Freak 2 performs better than the Zoom Freak 1. So yeah, good job Nike and good job Giannis Antetokounmpo for basically upgrading your shoe. Again, if you guys want to cop either of these shoes, I'll leave links below. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one.